In standard Git mode, you can now check out branches from tags. In the repository drop-down menu, select a tag and then check out as local branch from the submenu. In the dialog box, enter a name for your new branch, and click OK to create the branch and switch to it. Click Push in the repository drop-down menu. The new branch is shown on Git side. In standard Git mode, you can now add a message when creating tags. In the repository drop-down menu, select More, Add Tag. In the new tag dialog box, enter a name for your new tag based on the selected source, add a message to the tag, and click OK. When done, the tag you created will be listed on the repository drop-down menu. On Git side, you can see that the new tag is created and the message is shown. The April release brings you the capacity to work with Iceberg tables in your Spark batch jobs using Spark 3.1 onwards. The following three brand new components are now available in the databases family from the palette. Let's take a closer look at the components. First, you have the T-Iceberg input component, which allows you to read data from an Iceberg table by simply mentioning the Iceberg table name. Then, you can use T-Iceberg output to write data into an Iceberg table. The actions can be made either into an existing table, or you can directly create a new one. Finally, you can use T-Iceberg catalog, which allows you to register a new Iceberg catalog. The supported catalogs are Hadoop, Hive, REST, and Custom. For example, if you run your Spark batch jobs on EMR 6.5, with the custom type, you can work with AWS Glue catalog, by specifying the name in the catalog implementation parameter and adding an extra property in the table, mentioning the warehouse in which the Glue catalog is stored as follows. In this release, a Dockerfile view is added under the build node of the project settings dialog box, allowing you to customize the Dockerfile settings to build your Docker images. You can change the containers, users, and other commands as needed.